past journal entries and entry to the system of Praveen Limited. Okay, fine. Raw material purchase 70% credit, that means 30% is cash. Okay, this part is easy. Material return to C Limited from stock. C Limited is my creditor. So he has returned me the goods. So obviously this is purchase return ka entry. Yeah, fine. So depreciation on machine. Okay. So kuch bola nahi hai. Indirect ya direct method hai. So obviously a direct method hai, because for the indirect method, you need to have provision for depreciation in the trial balance. Okay. So this is definitely the first method, the direct method of AS 6. So depreciation on machine. The machine is a part of which, it is used for which purpose? Factory purpose. So my journal entry for this will be, depreciation account debit to machinery, but I will not write depreciation. I will make it more specific. It will be allocated to factory because it is for factory purpose. So factory overheads ledger control account debit to plant and machinery account. Okay, so this is what you're going to write. Next, cost of goods produced means COP entry. Actually, a few students told me to discuss few questions. So question number 10 is one of them. So manufacturing overheads payable bola hai. Okay, payable means it is outstanding. Okay, yeah. So if you remember, you guys, I have done with you all a terminology called as creditors for expense account. Yeah, so this is that. Okay, so the journal entry will be obviously factory overheads ledger control account debit to, you can write outstanding factory overheads or creditors for expense. So I had told you the logic for using creditors for expense account. Okay, in one of the lectures I had said. Okay, kya hota hai? Factory overheads payable, your admin overheads payable, selling and distribution payable, wages payable. So aise char entry agar aa gayi payable ki, so aapko char aur ledgers banane padenge. Outstanding wages account, outstanding FOH, outstanding AOH, outstanding S&D. So instead of taking that pain and efforts to make four more ledgers, it's better we make only one ledger which clubs all these four ledgers known as creditors for expense account. Okay, yeah. And then yes, this entry is very, very important. Actually, this entry ki wajah se I'm discussing this sum with you. Yeah. Purchase of materials for immediate repair work from unknown. So if you read between the lines, so you can get two meanings out of this particular transaction. First, purchase of material. Okay, if you read it like this, purchase of material means you're purchasing raw material. But what is the purpose of purchase? For immediate repair work from unknown. So agar aap aise padho to aisa lagta hai ki anu se aapne raw material liya hai. This is also one way you could think. And if you read it again, so it could also be purchase of raw material. Okay, for what purpose? For repair work purpose, which was given from unknown. Okay, so yeah, like this. So the journal entry for this is, yeah, now see carefully what I'm writing. Yeah, you can write repair work. Repair work is a part of factory. Okay, so factory overheads ledger control account debit to WIP ledger control account. Or you can even pass this entry. Okay, if you remember, I have told you this logic also. Repair work hai. Okay, so already tumne pehle 10 rupaya kharcha kar diya hai raw material pe. Okay, samne wale ne tumko goods wapis bhej diya. Okay, so samjho wo samne wala is Anu. Anu has returned the goods to you on the pretext that repair it and give it to her back. You have to repair it and give it to her back. Okay, so yeah, you're doing that. So while repairing, okay, to repair that goods, you have purchased this raw material. So say, tumne aur 2 rupaya kharcha kiya. ओके तो अभी कितना हो गया 12 रुपया, बट अनु हैज ऑलरेडी टेकन फ्रॉम यू एट 10 एंड दिस 2 रुपीज एक्स्ट्रा विच यू आर पुटिंग फ्रॉम योर पॉकेट अनु विल नॉट पे टू यू. वाई? ऑब्वियसली बिकॉज यू विल बेयर ना, यू आर द मैन्युफैक्चरर, सो यू विल बेयर दैट 2 रुपीज. सो दिस 2 रुपीज इज द कॉस्ट टू माई पॉकेट. Okay, it's a loss to me. She is not going to pay me this 2 rupees. Okay, so that is why you can even pass entry FPL to WIP. This is called as WIP rejected. The other meaning of this transaction is WIP rejected. So if a student passes this entry FOH to WIP, it is not wrong because repair work is done at the factory level only. Okay, yeah. Am I clear about this entry? Either of the one. Is the entry clear to everyone? Just acknowledge it in the chat box. Okay, so these are minute details which students don't pay attention to and make mistake in journal entries. And if the journal entry is wrong, obviously the posting in the ledger is wrong. And if the posting is wrong, then the ledger balances when you do, that is also wrong. Okay, next. Salaries payable to Rocky. Okay, irrespective. It is payable, na? It is outstanding. Okay, yeah. So what journal entry I'll pass? Salaries is a part of office. So admin, overheads, ledger, control account, debit to creditors for expense account. Okay. Next, return of indirect material to stores. Okay. Indirect material is returned. Fine. So stores ledger control account debit to FOH ledger control. Okay? Yeah. Then cash sales 25%, baki ka 75% is credit, that means. Okay, don't forget that part. Cost of spoiled and defective work taken out of process. Okay, this is also loss. So my journal entry will be FPL to WIP. Okay, and then over absorption. Okay, over absorption. First, we will check pay ka entry is given. No, not given. Charge ka entry is given. Not given. Okay, so but what steps do we follow? Pay, charge, and absorption. So these are the entries that we follow. Okay, so I'll just show it to you. So when you prepare selling and distribution overheads ledger control account, over absorption ka journal entry is selling and distribution overheads account debit to FPL. So one effect will go here, FPL. How much? 15,000. Okay. Now I don't know how much is charged. मुझे नहीं पता charge कितना है और paid कितना है. ठीक है. So that part I don't know. So I just know one thing कि this is the I mean, when we pass journal entry stepwise, pay, charge, absorption is always the balancing figure. So this concept we know. So go reverse, do reverse engineering. Then, okay, यहाँ पे 15 का balance तब आएगा जब ये double होगा 30. So when I close this ledger, बराबर ना, it is charged to COS. And that means the paid entry is 15. Okay, so if 30,000 is here, 30 माइनस 15 तो कैश इज ऑल्सो 15. अब बराबर हो रहा है, पे इज 15, चार्ज इज 30, देन द ओवर एब्जॉर्प्शन इज. ओके, गॉट दिस पॉइंट क्लियर एवरीवन? वी आर डूइंग रिवर्स इंजीनियरिंग. या हम थर्ड स्टेप से फाइनल फर्स्ट सेकेंड फिर फर्स्ट स्टेप पे जा रहे हैं. Acknowledge in the chat box. Is this part clear to everyone? Okay, so this sum looks easy, but see, it has so many tricky adjustments, so many tricky transactions in it. Okay, so this is one part of discussion done. Okay, thanks, dear. Yeah. So this sum is very important. Yeah, see, it has many tricky parts associated in one sum. Okay, yeah. Next that I wanted to discuss was this sum. So I'm discussing all these sums on request, of students. Obviously, students who are practicing are getting doubts. If you don't practice, how will you get doubts? Okay, so those who are practicing, they have said, ma'am, myself, there are so many adjustments, we are confused. So that is why I took up this sum today, 10. I'm discussing the journal entry part, then later ledger and trial balance part you can take care of, you can do that. Then question number 12, yeah, just go through this question there. ओके, क्या बोला है? प्रिपेयर अ नेसेसरी लेजर अकाउंट्स एंड ट्रायल बैलेंस अंडर इंटीग्रल अकाउंट्स. ट्रायल बैलेंस आल्सो दे हैव आस्क्ड टू प्रिपेयर ऑब्वियसली द क्लोजिंग, बट इफ यू लुक इनटू द क्वेश्चन देयर इज नो ट्रायल बैलेंस, देयर इज नो ओपनिंग ट्रायल बैलेंस इन द क्वेश्चन, देन हाउ विल आई प्रिपेयर अ क्लोजिंग ट्रायल बैलेंस. Okay, we have done one similar type of sum. अगर opening trial balance नहीं है तो opening balances जरूर होगा, only opening balances that will be there in the question. It's there, see this one from here till here. Okay, so these are opening balances given to you. Okay, so what do you have in opening balance? You have share capital, reserves, creditors, plant and machinery, debtors, closing stock and cash. Okay, and then you have your normal transactions, stores purchased, so you know, raw material purchased, stores issued to production, raw material issued to production, stores in hand, matlab closing stock of raw material. Okay, yeah. Next, direct wages incurred means paid. Direct wages charged to production 60,000. That means balance 5,000 is charged to factory. Indirect wages, right? I have always told you, wages paid means it is always direct and indirect both together. Okay, yeah. So direct wages incurred. Okay, they have said it is direct wages incurred. Okay, then I'll discuss this part with you. Wait. Okay, let me discuss that. So when you make wage control account, yeah, pay attention, everyone. When you are making wage control account, you will first pay direct wages. So journal entry is wage control to cash. How much you will pay? 65 lakhs. Okay. Fine. Then they have said, direct wages charged to production. So how much is charged? WIP. Direct wages is charged to which account? WIP. How much? 60 lakhs. Okay. So here, yeah, that means the balance. When you close wage control account, the balance Now they have said only direct wages are paid. That means indirect wage, direct wages incurred. They have only mentioned direct wages as paid. There is no indirect wages in the sum. See, if you look into the question, kahin bhi indirect wages bola nahi hai. So this is the first sum where wages will be paid. I mean direct wages. Direct wages is paid. इनडायरेक्ट के बारे में कुछ नहीं बोला है तो आप अज्यूम नहीं कर सकते हो बिकॉज पूरा का पूरा 65 लाख यू हैव पेड फॉर डायरेक्ट वेजेस ओनली, यू हैव नॉट पेड फॉर इनडायरेक्ट वेजेस. क्लियर? हाँ. एंड डायरेक्ट वेजेस चार्ज इज हाउ मच? 60 लाख. दैट मींस पे चार्ज एंड दिस इज एब्जॉर्प्शन एंट्री. यू आर गोइंग टू टेक इट टू एफपीएल. हाउ मच? 5 लाख. So, how much, what is the balance? 5 lakhs. Okay, 5 lakhs. So I always, you remember, I always tell you pay, charge, absorption. And sometimes, we haven't done sums yet. Aisa koi sum abhi tak mila hai nahi. Generally, the wage control account tallies. But see, this is the first sum where the wage control account will not tally. Why? Because indirect wages information is missing. They have clearly said direct wages are paid. No indirect. Okay, total word use hi nahi kiya hai. Okay, yeah. So, yahan pe agar aap 5 lakhs indirect wages mein daloge, toh wrong hoga. It would be a wrong adjustment, a wrong treatment with the transaction. Okay. And they have clearly said direct wages is charged to production. So pay, charge, and this is under absorption entry. Okay, clear everyone? Is this point clear? Just acknowledge it in the chat box. So when you solve sums, you get doubts, obviously. Next, manufacturing incurred this, that. Finished goods, stock production at cost. Okay. And sales is given. Closing stock is given. Okay. Yeah. Can anybody tell me? Ye stores in hand hai. This is closing stock of raw material. So, ye kaun sa closing stock hai? Okay. ये कौन सा क्लोजिंग स्टॉक है? ऑलरेडी वी हैव क्लोजिंग स्टॉक स्टोर्स इन हैंड. स्टोर्स वर्ड इज यूज्ड ना, तो इट इज क्लोजिंग स्टॉक ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल. तो ये वापस जो क्लोजिंग स्टॉक दिया है, ये कौन सा क्लोजिंग स्टॉक है? या वेरी गुड सायतन, इट इज फिनिश गुड्स का क्लोजिंग स्टॉक. ऑब्वियसली क्लोजिंग स्टॉक ऑफ फिनिश गुड्स. ओके, या तो पेमेंट टू क्रेडिटर्स इज गिवन, रिसीव फ्रॉम डेटर्स. ये तो सब नॉर्मल जर्नल एंट्रीज है, यू नो अबाउट. Okay, clear? And now, what to do with this opening balance? Trial balance to hai nahi, correct? Opening trial balance is not there. So when you make closing trial balance, it will not tally. But it has to tally. How will it tally? I'll tell you. Now, we know that for every debit, there is an equivalent credit effect. And for every credit, there is an equivalent debit effect. Vice versa. Okay, this is the double entry system of bookkeeping, the rule hai ye. Correct? So this concept I'm going to use here. अगर आप ये कॉन्सेप्ट नहीं लगाओगे तो आपको क्लोजिंग ट्रायल बैलेंस टैली नहीं होगा. ओके, सो मेक एन एफपीएल अकाउंट, ऑब्वियसली दैट यू विल बी मेकिंग. तो शेयर कैपिटल, शेयर कैपिटल कैपिटल हैज क्रेडिट बैलेंस राइट. तो वन इफेक्ट इज देयर इन क्रेडिट. आई विल गिव द सेकेंड इफेक्ट. सो आई विल राइट इट लाइक दैट. तो ओपनिंग बैलेंस ऑन द डेबिट साइड, शेयर कैपिटल, ओके, देन रिजर्व्स ऑल्सो हैव क्रेडिट बैलेंस. तो सेकेंड इफेक्ट डेबिट साइड रिजर्व्स. Creditors also have credit balance, so I will give an equivalent debit effect on the debit side, creditors. Okay, plant and machinery are assets, assets have debit balances, so I will give an equivalent credit effect. Okay, yeah, so plant and machinery, then debtors also same, it's debit balance, so I will give an equivalent credit. Then closing stock, I will give an equivalent credit. Cash balance, I will give an equivalent credit. Is this clear? Now your trial balance will tally, the closing trial balance. Okay, this part has to be done. Am I clear about this? Acknowledge it in the chat box. Is this part clear to everyone? Yeah, this is also important transaction. October 2008 question. Iska ye second wala question. There are two questions. Question number 12. There are two questions. Yeah. So this one I had done. Ye wala maine kiya tha. Isme trial balance diya tha. Ye wala. This I have done. And one similar sum like this I have done. So that is why I did not do this question. But see, it has variations. मैंने जो opening balance वाला sum लिया था उसमें सिर्फ सब debit balances ही थे, credit एक भी नहीं था. तो इसलिए जब आप ये sum करोगे तो ऐसे confused हो जाओगे, अरे मैम ने तो सब debit वाले लिए थे. तो यहाँ पे कुछ नहीं, credit debit दोनों mix है, कुछ नहीं. क्रेडिट है तो उसको ऑपोजिट डेबिट इफेक्ट दो, डेबिट है तो ऑपोजिट क्रेडिट इफेक्ट. ओके, या थैंक्स नेहा. फाइन, सो दीज आर द यू नो इम्पोर्टेंट हाईलाइट्स ऑफ अ क्वेश्चन. नॉट ऑल क्वेश्चंस आर वन एंड द सेम. देयर हैज टू बी अ ट्विस्ट इन एवरी क्वेश्चन. देयर इज वन टू थ्री ट्विस्ट, उससे ज्यादा नहीं होता. ठीक है, so note down this question, do practice it. First sum where wage control will not tally. Till date whatever sums we have done, wage control always tally, but in this question it will not, because it is specifically given direct wages is paid. Okay, you can, agar bola hota wages paid, then I would have assumed ki direct and indirect both are paid. Okay, then fir main wo 5 lakhs factory mein dalti. I would have considered it to be an indirect wages, this one, and I would have put it to factor. But yahan aisa koi information nahi hai. They are very specific. You only direct wages is paid and direct wages is charged. So balance 5 lakhs is under absorption. Okay. Ye wala question I had done. Then this question number 13 also I had discussed with you guys. Yeah. Then question number 14 also I had discussed with you all. Okay, because it was similar to this question. Question number 13 and 14 are similar to question number 12. Okay, are similar to this question. So the only twist I had explained, rest I had told you already. Okay, so practice this sums. I don't want to waste time on similar sums, so I did not do that. Okay, now see this question number 15. Okay, इसमें भी थोड़ा सा twist है. Okay, क्या twist है देखते हैं. Okay, pass necessary journal entries and prepare trial balance बोला. ठीक है, okay. तो यहाँ पे तो ना opening balance दिया है, ना opening trial balance दिया है, and they want you to prepare a trial balance. So you obviously you'll have to prepare it. And obviously the figures are such, it will tell you, because for every journal entry you're giving a debit and a credit, both the effects, so the trial balance will tell you. Raw material purchased. Okay, so kuch bhi nahi bola hai, so I have said an integral. You have to consider it to be a credit purchase. This entries we are done with. Okay, see this entry. Okay, wages pay. Ab yahan pe aisa kuch bola nahi hai. यहाँ पे क्या बोला है 7,20,000 वेजेस पेड, 30% इज इनडायरेक्ट, तो 7,20,000 इज माय टोटल वेजेस, आउट ऑफ विच 30% दे आर सेइंग इट इज इनडायरेक्ट वेजेस, तो इट इज बट अंडरस्टूड दैट बाकी का बैलेंस 70% इज डायरेक्ट वेजेस. ओके, सो 7,20,000 का 30% is how much? 2,16,000. Okay. Baki ka it is direct wages. 5,04,000. Okay. Then first what entry you will pass? Wages paid. So what is the entry? Wage control to cash fund. Obviously you will pay the total. 7,20,000. Okay, then you will charge wages charged. Okay, so how much you will charge? Direct wages. Okay, but direct wages charged to production kitna bola hai? 6,00,000 bola hai. Ab tumne pay 5,04,000 kiya hai, to tum 6,00,000 charge kar rahe ho, theek hai? So direct wages is charged to which account? WIP. So WIP, how much? 6,00,000. ठीक है, and और कुछ नहीं बोला है, ठीक है, but indirect wages भी तो तुमने pay किया है, तो ये भी तो charge करना पड़ेगा. So factory overheads ledger control account debit to wage control, 2,16,000. Okay, 2,16,000. Okay, so when you will make a wage control account, जब तुम wage control account बनाओगे, तो कैसे आएगा entry? To cash 7,20,000 by WIP 6,00,000 by FOH. In absence of information, we'll assume whatever is paid for indirect wages is fully charged. Is how much? 2,16,000. Okay, so now check. 6,00,000 plus 2,16,000 is how much? 8,16,000. There is a balance. 96. Put it to FPL. Over absorption. Clear? Yeah. Just note it down. Acknowledge it in the chat box. Okay. Acknowledge it in the chat box. The second sum where wage control doesn't tell you. Okay, so jo important element hai wo maine aapko bata diya hai, rest pura sum aapko karna hai. Okay, practice it. Finished products at cost means cost of sales entry. Okay, so next lecture I'll be starting with a new chapter. Equivalent process costing. Okay. So these three sums which I discussed today, yeah, practice them.